do it by allowing people who are here illegally to become legal citizens.
All right, candidates.
And we don't have to do it by pulling people over based upon the color of their skin.
If you would like to continue this discussion, we have a perfect opportunity right now because we're going to move to our second round of candidate-to-candidate questions. Again, each candidate will get 30 seconds to ask their question, and their opponent will get up to 90 seconds to respond. Mrs. Custer, you'll get to go first this time around.
Congressman Bass, you had 12 years in Washington, and you voted for all the policies that devastated our economy, including the deregulation of Wall Street. You voted to allow the big banks to trade the risky derivatives and credit default swaps that led directly to the crash. And then after the crash, you represented a group of Republicans who cheered on and, in fact, advocated for the Wall Street bailout that I opposed. But when it came to reforming Wall Street, you called the bipartisan reform law, quote unquote, extremist. Why do you keep standing up for Wall Street banks over New Hampshire families?
Well, first of all, that's a ridiculous charge. You have accused me in the course of this campaign of being of voting to raise veterans' benefits, which I never did, or to lower them, rather. For Bernie Madoff, for the BP oil spill, I don't know, for the loss of 4,000 jobs in Nashua that apparently never existed, and now you have this complicated sort of train where at some point I cast a vote here or there that did something that caused the entire ruin of the U.S. economy. I'll tell you something. This is not a campaign about those kinds of issues. This is a campaign about where we need to be a year ago from today. And it's not going to be where we are today. And the choice that you all have before you tonight is between somebody who has spent the last 3 months talking about my issues in Congress and picking apart my voting record, which I'm proud of, and trying to ignore the real issue here, which is why is unemployment at 9.7%? Why do we have $1.5 trillion deficits? Why is it that the Obama administration has really run out of ideas to turn this economy around? We need change in Washington, and we need it now.
Mr. Bass, your question for Mrs. Custer.
For years, Annie, you have supported a state income tax for New Hampshire. Do you still think that's a good idea?
I don't support an income tax, and what this bill, what this campaign is all about is federal taxation. Here's what I'm opposed to. Taxation that rewards corporations over people in their real lives. Congressman Bass voted for taxes to encourage companies to ship jobs overseas. I think we need to close those tax loopholes. I want to focus on tax relief for middle-class families, for hardworking New Hampshire families, families that I've met all across this district. That's where we need to focus tax relief. And small business. 65% of New Hampshire people work in small business. I've proposed tax relief for repealing the capital gains tax for investment in small business. Congressman Bass has opposed that idea. But I want to stay focused on tax relief for middle-class families so that we can create jobs and get everyone back to work. That's what people want, and they need a new approach in Washington.